Good evening, everybody. God bless you. Welcome to Wednesday Night Bible Study, Kingdom Worship Center Online. So glad that you joined me tonight as we get ready to come around the table of God's Word and study on how to be balanced as a believer. But I want you to enjoy this song tonight. It's from Vertical Worship, Come Holy Spirit. It's a beautiful song. Enjoy this song. God bless you. Praise your coming on. Rushing like a flood, heaven opened up. Come in never-ending waves, I am swept away. Holy Spirit, come. I wanna hear the voice the storm obeys. I wanna feel your presence. New Year's celebration with family and friends. Praise God. Welcome to 2024. It's hard to believe it's 2024 and it's already upon us. This is the year of evangelism and it's the year, as we said to you, of reconciliations and restorations, reinstitutions and restitutions. Praise God, and recompense. It's that type of year. Praise God. And I tell you, we're going to see a lot of it in the church and we're going to see a lot of it in the world. And as I have already prophesied, that there's going to be recompense and restitutions. We're starting to see what's happening, even as they begin to expose some of the things that went down in the U.S. When it came to this Epstein Island and other things. We're going to see a lot of recompense this year as God is going to make things right. And if something has happened to you, some things are going to be made right in your behalf because God sees and hears the cry of those who have been afflicted by others. And it's coming. It's coming. I prophesied to you, and it's not a coincidence that we're already seeing things happening in the world. because the prophetic word is true. So glad to see you all on tonight. Praise God. And I'm releasing my faith that in 2024, you're going to have a fantastic year. It's a turnaround year for you. Amen. And glad to see you all coming on. And I always love watching as the comments pop up on my screen of you encouraging one another as the family of God. Praise God. If you have your Bibles, let's get into the Word of God tonight. I want to talk about the importance of balance, and especially in the context of this year, being a balanced believer. Praise God. And I like that Linda put up there. It's a turnaround year. Absolutely. Absolutely. There's a lot of recompense, as I said earlier, and restitution coming. And we're going to see it in the secular world, and we're going to see it in the body of Christ in the church. Praise God. Now, I want to talk about the importance of balance in the context of you as a believer, the context of us as a church, as Kingdom Worship Center, or whatever church or wherever church you attend and where you worship, that you would be able to talk to your pastor, talk to the body there at your church, and pray for the body at your church to bring about balance. Praise God. So if you have your Bible, we're going to go to Ephesians chapter 1, verse 13 through 14 first. And that's where we're going to begin. The balance tonight. You're probably wondering, what balance is Pastor Peter talking about? Well, we're going to find out just in a second. Amen. You know, I like to keep people in suspense. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 13 through 14 says this: In him, Christ, you also who have heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and have believed in him, were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, which is the guarantee of our inheritance until we acquire possession of it to the praise of his glory. Praise God. I want to talk about the balance that you need in your life in this year of evangelism, in this year of restitution and restoration, that you maintain a balance that's found in this scripture, the balance between the word and the spirit, and the spirit and the word. It's a balance that many Christians don't carry. It's a balance that many churches don't carry. And I want us to release our faith for Kingdom Worship Center and for all of the churches in this nation around the world, that there would be a balance between the Spirit of God and the Word of God. And that is important. And I'm going to explain why that's important in your life as we go on today. You know, John 4:24, you remember that story in the scriptures when Jesus met the woman at the well, and she said, you know, our fathers do worship at this mountain. And the Lord said, well, there's coming a time where you won't worship at this mountain. And I'm just going to paraphrase here some of it to hit the main point. And that's where he says that true worshipers would worship him in spirit and in truth. That's the balance that I want to really hit on tonight. And there's going to be a huge blessing that comes out of this in 2024. So it is spirit and truth. Truth is the word of God. God's word is true. Truth is Jesus. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And Jesus, according to John 1:1, is the word. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. So the word of God with the spirit of God helps bring good balance to our lives so that we can walk in the blessing of God and stay connected in the freshness of our salvation, as well as being a true and powerful witness for Christ. I want to do a series coming up here on the gifts of the Holy Spirit and really dig into that, because it is the year of evangelism and we need the nine gifts of the Spirit in full operation in the church and in our personal lives. We need the gifts of the Spirit in order to reach the lost. But if we don't have the balance of the Word of God with the Spirit of God and the Spirit of God with the Word of God, then we can become ineffective in our walk and the ministry in which God has called us to. You know, Paul told the church in Corinth this in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 6. He said this: He said, the letter killeth, but the spirit gives it life. And that's a powerful revelation. The letter killeth, but the spirit gives it life. The letter of the law can kill. Aren't you glad we're not under the law, but we're under grace, and we've received that grace through his death, burial, and resurrection and faith in his name, and that it's the spirit of God who brings life into us. So the word of God by itself can cause somebody to be feel condemned, but it's the spirit of God connect it with the word of God that brings life to it all. And that's the balance that we need in this very, very strategic transitional year that God has made for all of us in 2024. Amen. I see some of you coming on now. Good evening. Thank you for joining us tonight. We're so glad that you're joining us, Darlene and others. God bless you. It is a mistake. Now, let me say this. Here's some notes I jotted down today. It's a mistake to emphasize one of these at the exclusion of the other. What am I talking about if you're coming on late? It's the spirit and the word. That's the balance of a believer. So it is a mistake. It's detrimental to emphasize one of these to the exclusion of the other. It's detrimental to exclude the word of God from the moving of the spirit, or to for us seeking spiritual things, to exclude the word of God. It's also detrimental to exclude the Holy Spirit moving in our lives and in our church, and just focus on the word. You need them both. That's what Paul was trying to say in Ephesians chapter 1 verse 13, that we need the word and the spirit. Praise God. I like this. Brother Shambach shared this with me years ago. All word, no spirit, people dry up. All word, no spirit, people will dry up. All spirit, no word, people can blow up. I thought that was great. Now, I've heard somebody add to that. With the word and the spirit in our lives and in our church, we grow up. But where there is no spirit and there's only the word, you can become stagnated and dry, because the letter by itself can kill, but the spirit gives it life. And where there's all spirit, and that's hunger for spirit, for the things of the spirit, without the word, we can blow up. Churches that are all words are very usually dry, stagnant churches. Christians that are all word. Now, it's important. You know me. I love the word of God. I was having a lunch with some wonderful man of God today, and I'll tell you, we had this conversation. We both said we love the word of God. And I know you too. Maybe you want to put that up on the screen. That you love the word of God. Genesis to Revelation, which is the manifold wisdom of God. But churches that are primarily focused on the word and just primarily focused on doctrine can be very dry and stagnated places. And Christians who really know their word and really focus in on doctrine and dogma can become very dry, stagnant believers and lack the zeal and the enthusiasm of the kingdom. And then where there is no spirit, let me say this, all the freshness and the vitality that the spirit brings can be reduce us and the church to mechanical, to being mechanical, to being orthodox, to being perfunctory. Perfunctory is really lacking enthusiasm and excitement and a zeal and a joy concerning the word of God. So the word of God becomes very just mechanical and orthodox, and there's no zeal, there's no in the performance and the presentation of the word. And I've been in those places. I'm sure you've been in those places. I've been around those type of believers. You know, the word of God says, or brother, the word of God says, or, you know, they're so focused on being accurate in scripture, which is very important, but they do that with not allowing the Spirit of God to be present. And then it becomes simple, orthodox, mechanical performance with no life in it. And where there's no life, there's really no excitement or anticipatory spirit concerning the things that are in God's Word. So, dear saints of God, in 2024, it is absolutely essential that you carry that balance in your life. Now, where there is no spirit, I'm going to come to the word in a second. Where there is no spirit, without found, where there's no spirit, there's no life. But where there is no word, no word. So you got all, where you got all of these people who are so focused on, getting that move of the spirit and hungry for the things of the spirit, and they don't want the word. And they want to prophesy with no context of the word, and want to stand out with the spirit and move in the gifts without the word, and the word is not there. That type of believer can go into error very quickly, I have found. So that is dangerous. Absolutely, Claver. Robotic, almost no joy. There is no joy. So this is the balance that you want to have in your life. And the reason why I'm sharing this is because we're leading in this year of evangelism, this year of restoration, and this year of restitution and reinstatement and recompense, and that there's going to be moves of God amongst your family and restorations between parents and all the things that I prophesied. If you missed it, watch the Sunday morning service at our church if you're not a part of our church. But this is the balance that's going to be so essential in seeing these things through. Because we need believers to walk in the Spirit, walk in the gifts, but we also need believers to stand firmly and be foundational upon the Word of God. Because where there is Spirit and the hunger for the things of the Spirit, and there's no Word, that person, that church, those Christians, those believers can slide away in error because they put the experience above even being accurate biblically. And that's a dangerous place also. So I see some folks coming on a little bit late. So where there's no spirit, people can dry up. Where there's only the things desire for the spirit, things of the spirit, people can go into error and blow up. And the balance is both, as Paul said in Ephesians 1:13. So churches where there's where this, they have the spirit without foundational truth can go into false doctrine. They can go into things that are really strange. And the enemy can lead them there because there's no real foundation and everything and anything goes. And because it felt spiritual and it came across as spiritual, people accept it. And I've been in those places. And I know many of you probably been in those places, and I've been around those believers. Just because somebody says, "Thus saith the Lord," doesn't mean it's "Thus saith the Lord." Just because somebody says, "I got a word from the Spirit," doesn't mean it came from the Spirit. The one thing is true, that the Spirit will never contradict the word. And I like what Terry just said, it can become flaky without a doubt. And you can be around flaky believers, where they're way up in the sky and they're not down in this place of being rooted and grounded in biblical truths. So, family, I want to encourage you to hunger for the Holy Spirit this year. I want you to, like the song was played at the beginning, come, Holy Spirit, come with a freshness, come with a fresh touch, come with your presence and your giftings and your fruit, come with your glory, come with your manifestation, but also stay and remain within the word of truth. Because I have seen a lot of these preachers say they're prophets and they're not prophets. And I've seen a lot of these ministers come out and say, "Thus saith the Lord," and it's not even scriptural. And thus it's not from God. So let's maintain that balance. Because I want to encourage you to long for the gift of prophecy. because the Bible tells us to. I want you to be zealous concerning spiritual gifts, because we need to in a year like this year. Praise God. And I want you to long for the manifestation of the Spirit and His glory within your personal life, but also within the body of Christ, and that that move of the Spirit would grow exponentially at Kingdom Worship Center, and wherever you go to church, that the move of the Spirit would grow exponentially in every aspect of the ministry and every aspect of your personal life and your personal ministry, but not at the expense of going into error and false doctrine. So that is so important. Ima, God bless you. Thank you for joining us for the first time. Amen. So without the Word of God, the church, let me say this to you. Without the Word of God, and only wanting things that are spiritual and not also biblical, without the Word of God, the church can go into mysticism, and believers can go into mysticism and fanaticism. And those are real. Those are real. And you don't want to be there. You don't want to be there. Where everyone does what's right in their own eyes, and again, everyone accepts it just because it looked spiritual. Just because somebody shakes their hand doesn't mean it's going to come across as being true. And just because somebody gives a shiver or a shake, which I have done that, I've gotten felt the presence of God like electricity going through my body, but it's going to be foundational and true. It's going to be biblical. Praise God. And I don't want to be in that place as a believer where I just walk around with biblical truth with no spirit, because I'll come across as dead and dry, and there'll be lifeless and no power behind it. And so again, we need that balance. Amen. Praise God. So again, where there's no spirit, people dry up. Where there's no word, people can go into error. And we as a church, we want to be balanced. I have found in my walk with God, many of you could probably testify to this, God is very balanced. Amen. It's us believers who go to extremes, or just human beings go into these extremes. But God is very balanced in what He does. Perfect in all that He does. And we can get there, and we can live there, and we can walk there, because all things are possible to them that believe. Now, the importance of the Holy Spirit in our lives this year. Extremely, extremely important in our lives this year. The presence of the Holy Spirit in the year of evangelism. In the year, again, you're going to hear me say it again, because I want you to speak it by faith and lay hold of this promise. In the year of reconciliations and relationship healings, where it seemed impossible, and it seemed like it would never happen, and those people would never walk together, or you and someone else would never walk together. In this year of that work, it's going to be a powerful work of the Holy Spirit. Praise God. So we need the Spirit of God. In the year of restitution, it's going to be a work of the Spirit and the promise of God, which is His Word. Hallelujah. So I want you to get very hungry for the Holy Spirit this year. Get very hungry for a daily presence of the Holy Spirit. Because we can go about life, family. We can go about life and forget the Holy Spirit. We can go about church and forget about the Holy Spirit. And again, we need the Spirit of life to bring life to our walk with God. Hallelujah. Because remember how important the Holy Spirit is to us. The Holy Spirit was active, since it was just Christmas, the Holy Spirit was active in the birth of our Lord and Savior, as we see in Luke chapter 1, verse 35. He was active in the birth of our Savior. Hebrews 9:14 tells us He was active when Jesus presented Himself to God as a sacrifice for our sins. It was a work of the Holy Spirit in the life of Jesus, and He is the living Word of God. So you'll see that balance throughout Scripture. Spirit, Word, Word, Spirit. Praise God. Amen. Again, I don't want to go in error, and I don't want to be dry. I want my faith to be alive, and I want my faith to be active, and I want to be enthusiastic about the things of God and excited about what God is doing and what God can do and what God has promised. And that doesn't come just by the word, that comes by a touch of the Holy Spirit with the word of God in our lives. Amen. Remember, it was the Spirit that causes us to be born again in the new birth. Remember John 3:6, that which is born of flesh is flesh. That which is born of the Spirit is spirit. So we, our salvation is a work of the Word of God. Amen. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word. And when we heard that if you shall believe in your heart and confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus Christ, you'll be saved. When we heard the preaching of the word, we received it by faith, or our faith grabbed the hold of it, or faith came, the measure of faith came into us. And then it's a work of the Holy Spirit that brings us to the new birth. It's a work of the Holy Spirit that gives us life physically. It's a work of the Holy Spirit that gives us life spiritually. So the Spirit is needed, desperately needed in our lives. But I want to make sure we remain that in that balanced place. It's the Spirit that lives in the life of the believer. Praise God. It's the Spirit that lives in the life of the believer. Jesus promised us that in John 14, verse 17, that the Spirit would be with us. It's the believer that is sealed by the Holy Spirit. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 13. I believe we read that earlier. Praise God. We were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, Ephesians chapter 1, verse 13. And it's the Spirit of God in Romans 15, 16. It's the Spirit of God who sanctifies us. So let's call, say, come, Holy Spirit. 2024, I surrender my life. Surrender your life to the leading, the prompting, the touch, and the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. And maintain a powerful biblical foundation in your life. And stand upon the biblical promises of God, as well as these prophetic words that have come forward in 2024. Family, I know I heard from God. I know when I hear from God. I'm not one just to say, I prophesy. You don't hear that just all the time from me. Because I want to make sure that what I say is God and not myself. Because if I'm going to attribute to God, it better be God. And so I know I've heard from God concerning this year and the work of God and the command of God and the promises of God. It's going to require us to remain on strong biblical foundational truth and promises, with a fresh touch of the Holy Spirit in our lives. Praise God. And we can have both. Amen. Now, we cannot live. We need the Word, but you cannot live according to the Word without the Spirit of God. Okay? You can't. You cannot carry out this righteous walk without the help of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Can I get an amen on that? You see these orthodox, mechanical religious denominations demanding people to live by the word, and even they can't do it without the Holy Spirit. So what do? They say it's impossible, so just live any way you want to live. And this is why we're embracing all kinds of lifestyles, because we've allowed the Holy Spirit to leave, and now there's no strength to live in the word, and now they went into the error. So some places not only have went into the left the Holy Spirit, they've left the Word of God. They're in error on all fronts, and we don't want to be there. Praise God. We're going to remain true in the Holy Spirit, true and faithful to the Word. We cannot live according to the Word without the Spirit. We need the Spirit's help daily in our lives to walk this walk of faith and to walk in the Word and to fulfill the will and destiny of God in our lives. Amen. The Spirit of God, I wrote this down, the Spirit gives life and enables us to reach God's ultimate goals for us, to be transformed into the glorious image of His Son. That's the work of the Holy Spirit, and that's that balance that's so needed. praise God. The reason why some denominations reject the work of the Spirit, because they have seen, as Terry said earlier, the flakiness of a place that doesn't preach the word, but just allows everything and anything to go. So they reject the work of the Holy Spirit because they see the error of the people who have departed from strong biblical foundations. And so they disqualify the work of the Spirit, and they see believers who are flaky, and they're not, and they've strayed and went into the error away from the word of God. So they reject the work of the Spirit as they watch a believer who has all in the spiritual realm, this, well, so-called spiritual realm, without living truthful to the word. And so they reject it. We can't allow that to happen. We cannot allow our lives to reflect that type of behavior, because the work of the Holy Spirit is real. It doesn't matter what a denomination says. The work of the Holy Spirit is real. It doesn't matter what believers have done in error. The work of the Holy Spirit is essential and real. Praise God. Amen. And then we see those other places that are just word, word, word. And they're just hard, hard, hard. And their hearts are hard. And there's no enthusiasm and no spirit. And then you got all of these people who believe they're in the realm of the Spirit, rejecting sound biblical truth, because they look at it. Look at these people. They're just dry, 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 dry. So again, as we move forward in 2024, in the year of evangelism, in the year of these promises, we remain focused on these two things. We need the Spirit of God to help us live according to the Word, and that is so important. Amen. And I'm going to show you that in Scripture too. Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. I hope you're enjoying the teaching tonight. Sometimes I repeat myself because I see people coming on late, and I want them to be a part of what we're saying. I don't want them to be lost in and then just chime out because they don't really understand the context of the teaching tonight. So 2 Corinthians chapter 3, we're going to read verse 18. Praise God. But we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image. Praise God. Whose image? Christ, who is the glory of God manifested. But we are being changed from glory, from through the glory of the Lord, are being changed in the same image, which is Christ, from glory to glory, even as by the Spirit of the Lord. Even as by the Spirit of the Lord. So again, that word of God comes in, the washing of the water by the word, being transformed by the preaching of the word, and the work of the Holy Spirit is connected to that to bring us more into the image of Christ. That balance is everywhere in Scripture. Praise God. So I want you to pray yourself into it. I want you to study yourself into it. I want to encourage you to worship yourself into it, but remain in that powerful balance. Hallelujah, that is found and woven throughout the Scriptures. Praise God. Amen. And it's a work of the Holy Spirit for us to reach our ultimate goal in 2024. Paul teaches us the same truth. Here's something. But now, by dying to what once bound us, we have been released from the law, so that we might serve in the new way of the Spirit and not the old way of a written code. He said that in Romans 7, 6. So what he's saying is that we live in this new way of the Holy Spirit, not that old way of the Old Testament. We're living in the new way of the Spirit of God, but it's foundational and true in a biblical sense. Hallelujah. So we need to live in this powerful realm of the Spirit of God. And I'm praying for that this year, that you will have a fresh touch of the Holy Spirit upon your life. Praise God. And that you will have a new vitality in your faith under the unction, the guiding, and the leading, and the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. And you will be filled with the Word of God. You'll memorize scripture, you'll meditate on scripture, you'll be strong in the promises of God, and you'll be strong in the prophetic words that are coming forth from the Word of God. Amen. Now, as a side note again, family, I've always said to you, judge every prophetic word. Don't just accept it because somebody said they heard from God. Line it up, precept upon precept, line upon line, principle upon principle, upon the word of truth. Praise God. And allow the Spirit of God to work in all of that. Because it's going to keep you strong in 2024. It's going to help you fulfill God's call on your life in this year of evangelism. And it's going to help activate your ministry that's so needed in the body of Christ. Hallelujah. Could you imagine everybody, and we have a few hundred people at Kingdom Worship Center when we include everybody. Can you imagine all of us at Kingdom Worship Center? Could you imagine everybody at your local church so filled with the Word of God, so knowledgeable in the Scriptures, so understanding of the promises and the prophetic words, and being so led and empowered by the Holy Spirit, activating everyone into the ministry that God called them to do? Could you imagine the manifested power and the collective power that would come from a body of believers when that is transpiring in the church? Could you imagine what would happen? Oh, I can. I can't wait to see it. And I want, as a pastor, I want to lead our church that way in 2024. Praise God. Because there's a lot coming down. There is a lot of things going to happen this year. And you need both. You need that balance. Like I told you, it's a year of recompense and restitution and reinstitutions. And we're going to see it. You know what else we're going to see this year in that recompense? We're going to see a lot of things being exposed. And I said that. And I've said that. And I'll say it again. There's going to be a lot of exposure this year. There's going to be a lot of shaking this year in those who are not rooted in the Word of God and are not rooted in the Holy Spirit. And we're going to see a lot of exposing of things that were done that were wrong. Because that's what happens in restitution. That's what happens in reinstatements. That's what happens in recompense. Things that people have done to people are going to be exposed so that those people who things have been done to them would receive restitution. And there's going to be things exposed so that there can be reconciliations. That's this type of year. And you've got to remain strong in your most holy faith, in the word of truth, and in the power of the Holy Spirit. Praise God. Hallelujah. You got to. And God is going to shatter this year our people's dependence on man. God is going to shatter this year in many places people's following of men and women and putting them on pedestals higher than himself, higher than him. And this is going to be a powerful year. It's going to be an awesome year. I'm excited about this year because that which needs to be changed will be changed. That which needs to be adjusted will be adjusted. And I'm telling you, I like it, Edith. Many of you are saying, yes, I'm excited. Absolutely. I'm telling you this year, this is why I'm giving you this teaching of balance. Holy Spirit, Word of God, working together in our lives, activating our faith, enthusiastic about the promise. Hallelujah. And watching the manifestations. Praise God. Now let me give you another scripture, and we're going to close it up tonight. 1 John chapter 5, verse 7. Remember I told you that this balance is throughout the scriptures? It really is. It really is. Where you see the word, you'll see the spirit. Where you see the spirit, you will see the word. Amen. Prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, the Bible says, but holy men of God spake as the Spirit give them the utterance. So there's the word, and there's the spirit. Hallelujah. And here we are in 1 John chapter 5. Now, you're probably already there. I'm trying to flip there because I'm getting too excited now. Well, I'm never too excited, but I'm getting excited about the Word of God. Amen. When you're, listen, if you're watching us and your preacher at your church is not enthusiastic concerning the Word, there's a good chance that there's the Spirit of God is not allowed to have his way there. So pray for your church. Pray for your pastor. Pray for your leaders. Where there is the Spirit of God, the preacher, the teachers, the ministers will be enthusiastic about God. And there'll be a great, great, God bless you, Lena. Amen. God bless you, bless you, bless you. We love you. You know, there'll be an enthusiasm concerning the Word of God. There'll be an enthusiasm concerning praise and worship and the prophetic utterances of God. And the people will gravitate towards that. And you must this year, church. You must. When you go to church this year, you've got to get enthusiastic about what the word that's being preached. Enthusiastic and allow the Spirit of God to bring life into you concerning the word that comes forward from the pulpit, as well as enthusiastic and allowing the Spirit of God to get a hold of you for praise and worship, so you're not just a bump on the log. You're activated in God's presence with the saints in all of his glory. Somebody say amen. Now, I close with this. 1 John 5:7. You're going to see it woven through scriptures, as I told you. Let's go back to verse 4. Let's read all of that, okay? So, for whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. It's the importance of faith. Who is he that overcomes the world but he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God? We've overcome this world. We've overcome the World Economic Forum. We've overcome corrupt government. We've overcome the wickedness and the unrighteousness and the deception of this world because we are born of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Verse 6, this is he that came by water and by blood, even Jesus Christ. Not by water only, but by water and blood. And it is the Spirit that bears witness because the Spirit is truth. So by water and blood. Now we know that water in the Bible, by the washing of the water, by the Word of God, the Word, water represents the Word. Praise God. So, and Jesus is the Word. Praise God. The living Word. So where you see the Word, you see the Spirit. Where you see the Spirit, you see the Word. And the blood is there, working in conjunction with everything. That's the blood of our glorious Savior. Verse 7, the Bible says, and it is the Spirit that bears witness, because the Spirit is truth. For there are three that bear record in heaven. There are three that bear record in heaven. The Father, the Word, which is Jesus, and the Holy Ghost. And these three are one. Amen. One God. Praise God. One God who is the Father, who is Jesus, the Son of the living God, and who is the Holy Spirit. Amen. And these three are co-equal, coexistent, and are one. Amen. But you see there, there's the Spirit. And notice how John uses and refers to Jesus as the Word. The Spirit and the Word. The Father is there. The Spirit and the Word. The Word. I'm going to repeat this over. The Word and the Spirit. Pray for Kingdom Worship Center this year, family, that the Spirit and the Word will be working in the house. Pray in your own personal life this year. The Spirit and the Word will be working in your life and in your ministry and the call of God on your life and working his goodwill and pleasure in you and fulfilling these prophetic words that have been given to you, praise God, and the promises of God that are foundational in the Scripture. The Word and the Spirit and the Spirit and the Word working in you. Now let me read one more and we're done. Praise God. And there are three that bear witness in the earth, the Spirit and the water and the blood. And these three agree in one. Praise God. They agree. The Spirit and the Word and the blood on the earth are in agreement. This is why when you separate them, you're in big trouble. And I'm going to close with this thought. When a church separates the word from the spirit, it's in trouble. When a believer separates the word and the spirit, they're in trouble. When you hear people say, I love the word of God, but that spirit stuff, I don't want anything to do with it, they're in trouble. When I hear people say, I know the Bible, but we can't trust the Bible, so we've got to go by the spirit now, and only the spirit. And our church doesn't preach and open our Bibles. We just go with the flow. They're in trouble. They're in trouble because you are breaking apart an agreement and a unity that God created that exists in heaven, exists on the earth, and it must be together because it is a unified work. Praise God. It's a unified work that's essential. Essential. You separate them, disaster. Because you're bringing division between the two in your own life. And that's unacceptable. So it's the Word and the Spirit and the Word, working with the blood and the Father, the Son, and the Spirit of God working together. And the Bible says this, if we receive the witness of man, the witness of God is greater. Praise God. So when I hear people say, well, I know what the Bible says, but I say, well, we don't care what you say. We care what God is saying through his word. Hallelujah. Adjusting the Bible to suit their own mindsets. Dangerous. We're not living there. In 2024, we don't live there. We didn't live there last year. We're not living there this year. And especially this year of evangelism, restorations, reconciliations, restitution, reinstitution, and recompense. Praise God. If we receive the witness of man, the witness of God is greater, for this is the witness of God which he had testified of his Son. I'm going to stop right there. I can keep reading that beautiful portion of Scripture. So that's the balance. That's the balance. I'm going to be leading you into a season of teaching on the gifts of the Holy Spirit to you know, I know many of you know the word concerning that, but we've got to meditate and refresh it in us so that it lives and operates. I want to see every believer at Kingdom Worship Center operating in the gifts. I want to see every believer in Kingdom Worship Center and in this online family that's with us operating in the gifts and operating in the ministry in which God called you to minister in. This is not one preacher that gets intimidated because God's people are activated in their gifts. This is not one preacher who needs everybody just to follow him. This is a preacher, an apostle who wants you to walk in the call of God, the work of God, your ministry, and experience the promises of God and those prophetic utterances over your life. Praise God. And we're going to see it happen in 2024. It's going to be a great year. Amen. Well, I said a lot, didn't I, tonight? I love all your encouraging words. Thank you for your encouraging words, family. It really, really, really gives me strength. Praise God. And I love all your comments too, and all of your preaching online. It's so needed. It's so needed. So I love you all. Thank you. I see your comments coming up on the screen. God bless you, family. I close with this. You're going to hear it like a broken record, but I'm saying it because heaven repeats things. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. The whole earth is filled with his glory. They did not stop saying that at all. There are things that are constantly repeated in heaven, and there are things that we must continue to repeat in us. And I want to repeat it again. It's the year of evangelism, family. It's the year of reconciliations. It's the year of restorations, reinstitutions, reinstatements, and recompense. You're going to watch God work on your behalf. And you're going to watch God bring things back that were taken. And you're going to watch God heal relationships. And you're going to watch God use you to see souls saved. It's that type of beautiful year. You're going to do it under the power of the Holy Spirit and the authority of his word. And your faith is going to live and be alive in 2024. Thank you for sharing, everybody. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being a part of it. Thank you for participating. Thank you for all of your preaching and your comments and your encouraging words. I love you so much. Remember this, you're strong in the Lord and the power of his might. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Every word spoken against you shall fall at your feet. Hallelujah. You shall prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers in Jesus' mighty name. Your steps are ordered by God. You are led by the Spirit of truth. You are filled with the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Praise God. You have the angels of the Lord surrounding you. You are blessed to be a blessing. You are highly favored. Face of God looks upon you, shines upon you, and you have his peace and joy and life living inside of you. That's my prayer. That's my confession of faith for you. And I love you. God bless you, everybody. Have a terrific rest of your week. I'll see you Sunday morning at Kingdom Worship Center live, or I'll see you online, or if you're worshiping at the church you go to, may God bless that service, and may you have a wonderful experience with Jesus. God bless you, everybody. Have a terrific night.